eastern explorer Marco Polo crossed the arid Central Asian steppe to reach the Chinese Empire, then ruled by Kublai Khan. It was a long, arduous trek through a land of bandits, dust storms, and deadly scorpions. But it takes me just 5 hours in an air-conditioned minivan to cruise along the new Silk Road from Kazakhstan's largest city, Almaty, to the Chinese border. This eerily empty stretch of fresh tarmac is one piece of an ambitious peace corps being assembled by Kazakhstan's seemingly immovable president, Nursultan Nazarbayev. It leads to Khorgos Dry Port, where rail lines from China and Kazakhstan converge amid a collection of towering gantry frames and countless rows of shipping containers. Here, Chinese exports are transferred onto trains bound to destinations all over Central Asia and Europe. Trading nations traditionally grew by using the ocean. The dry port's commercial director, Nurlan Togenbayev, tells me that for Kazakhstan, our ocean is the 1.5 billion Chinese people who live over there, suggested across the featureless plain to the east. I drive another 10 minutes to the border itself. Here, Soviets and Chinese used to eyeball each other across a featureless no-man's land. Now, the Kazakhs and the Chinese are working together to build a new cross-border city, a free trade zone which will house hotels, casinos, a theme park, and a dizzying choice of duty-free shopping. Las Vegas, snorts the chief of the Kazakh Free Zone Authority, they're going to be bigger than Vegas. Since independence in 1991, Kazakhstan has relied heavily on its extractive industry. Oil, gas, and mineral reserves enabled the Nazarbayev regime to boost living standards while developing a brand.